Hey, YouTube, another commentary here by OMGABananaLol. This time I'll be showing you Kennen, the mother flippin' ninja. Oh yeah, he's freaking awesome. He's a badass. Is he a yordle, a hamster, a guy, a girl? Who cares? All you know is he screams, yeah, and he pwns her ass. Alright, let's start off with his masters. So Kennen, I like to go 10-20-0. 10 because I like to use Ignite and Flash as my summoner spell, so I like to get the extra 10 ability power when the Ignite is off cooldown, and then the rest of the 9 is for the 15% spell penetration, you know, all that stuff when you play a caster. 20, since you don't really need anything in utility, since you don't use mana, you're gonna go for more of a defensive build for advantage at the beginning, extra health, extra armor, extra everything, which is pretty awesome. For runes, I like to go pretty much my standard caster rune page, except for the yellows. I won't go mana per 5, I'll go armor. Some people say health per level, but I like to go flat armor, because at level 1, let's say you're midding the lane against Caitlyn, your armor is really going to give you a better chance to kill her. Res are going to be mage penetration, your quintessences are going to be flat AP, and your blues are going to be AP per level. So let's go through Kennen's abilities. So first of all, his passive is called Mark of the Storm. Kennen's abilities add 1 Mark of the Storm to opponents, which lasts for 8 seconds. An opponent is stunned for 1 second upon receiving 3 Marks of the Storm. Also, Kennen receives 25 energy. The stun has a dismissed effect if applied more than once within 7 seconds. So pretty much he can stun lots of people if he uses all of his abilities at the same time, which Kennen is just awesome for that. Through his other abilities, so his Q is called Thundering Shuriken. Kennen throws a fast-moving shuriken towards a location, dealing flat amount of damage plus 75% of ability power magic damage, and adding a Mark of the Storm to any opponent that it hits. Note that it cannot go through minions, it needs to be a direct hit. Kennen's W is called Electrical Surge. His passive, every 5 attack, Kennen deals magic damage equal to a flat amount of damage plus 80% of his attack damage, and marks a Mark of the Storm to his target. The active, Electrical Surge electrifies through all nearby targets afflicted by the Mark of the Storm, dealing a flat amount of damage plus 55% of ability power and adding another mark. So basically anyone that's enlightened by the Mark of the Storm, you will get hit by it. So that's really good for farming minions, very good for team fights, very good for anything. Kennen's E is called Lightning Rush. It's that little form that you see Kennen go in a spark. Pretty much it gives a movement speed, armor, and mage resistance. It deals a flat amount of damage plus 60% of his ability power. He's able to go through any units, but he cannot auto attack. It also adds a Mark of the Storm, and if he passes through one unit, it refunds 40 energy, but it only works once. Kennen's R, so his ultimate, is called Slicing Maelstrom. Kennen summons a magical storm that deals a flat amount of damage plus 40% of ability power to a random enemy inside the circle of the storm. Kennen at every 3 seconds. The storm hits up to 15 times at level 3 and with a 0.33 seconds delay between each bolt. It cannot hit the same target more than 3 times, but hitting it 3 times will automatically stun, plus your other 3 spells will can stun them twice. Plus your passive of your W, which you can maybe stun them even 3 times. Every time it hits the person, it adds a Mark of the Storm. Here's pretty much the combo that you're going to want to use with Kennen. You're going to want to flash in for the element of surprise if you like. You don't need to. Use your E, then use your ultimate, then use your W, and then use your Q. You can also use your Q to initiate the fight as well to get an automatic hit from the storm. Like I said, when using your combo, flash really helps the element of surprise. See, Ash was caught off guard. Even though she stunned me with her arrow, I stunned her as well. I stunned her twice, so she died instantly. So let's get into some items. I like to start with Amplifying Tome and a Health Potion, simply to give me that extra edge at the beginning, so lots of ability power for my Shuriken to do about 110 damage, which is awesome. Pretty much you're going to want to get your Sorcerer Shoes to get that extra magic penetration. You're going to want to get a Rallius Crystal Scepter to slow down your enemies after casting a spell, also giving you the survivability of 400 health, which is awesome. You're going to want to follow that by Erebaton's Death Cap to give you lots of ability power and a unique passive of 30% bonus ability power. And after, you want to gonna go with a Zhonya's Hourglass, simply because when you're in trouble in a team fight and you're doing all that combo and you like to initiate and stun everybody, you're gonna want a panic button. So that's gonna be your panic button. You're gonna be pressing whatever button you put the item on. I like to put it on 1 because it's closer to my pinky, I mean to my whatever Q up finger. So I just press Zhonya's Hourglass and then I'm safe. Note that you cannot use your Zhonya's Hourglass while you're CC'd, simply, I'm not sure why, or else it'd be overpowered. But yeah, so many times in a team fight I was CC'd, I was like, panic, and it wouldn't work. I was like, god damn it. So anyways, I checked the button at the edit button key, whatever, and I was like, what's going on? Is this right or what? Like, you'll see right here, I'll check it afterwards after I die. Anyways, you're gonna want to go with an Absol Scepter to give you that extra mage resist. So basically, from the Zanya's Hourglass and the Absol Scepter, you're gonna get extra armor and extra mage resist. So when you're using your E, you also get extra armor and extra mage resist, so that's gonna be awesome. Your last item, you're either gonna want to get Void Staff for extra mage penetration, or the Will of the Ancients to heal you while you cast your spells. So pretty much it's a give or take item, whichever you want, doesn't really matter. Like I always do, I tell my opinion about a champion. So where does Kennen stand? Is he overpowered? Is he balanced? Is he underpowered? Simply since his job is to initiate and stun everyone with his AoE and stuff like that, I think he's pretty balanced, simply because you'd say that he's overpowered since he can stun everybody in place and blah blah blah, but look at Amumu, look at Galio, look at all those tanks. Yes, they have less damage output than Kennen, but Kennen is much squishier, right, because you want to build him ability power. So basically, you can just CC him and he's pretty much screwed. So yes, he gets armor and mage resistance from his E and he can go really fast with it, but I mean, he's very squishy and very easily counterable just by CCing him, you know what I'm saying? So basically, since his job is to initiate and he's kind of squishy, I'd say he is pretty much balanced. So yeah guys, I'm back making YouTube videos for LOL. I know I just took maybe 2 or 3 weeks off. I was simply just not feeling, you know, in the mood to make videos, basically, but I'm back now. I'll be making videos regularly. School will be starting soon, so I'm not sure if I'll be making as many as I used to, but I will definitely try to do my best. I like doing stuff for you guys. If you like my videos, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Inbox me for any questions or any like suggestions for my next videos. Basically, if you like watching my videos, you could tell your friends about guides and stuff. If they need help for doing anything, you could add me in the game, play with me, ask me questions, whatever, it doesn't really matter. If you're gonna play Kennen, he's a very strong caster. He uses energy, you know, he's pretty elite, you don't need mana, it's pretty awesome. He's a ninja, you can't go wrong with that. He's like a freaking gerbil. If you wanna like screw fuck shit up with the gerbil, just play Kennen then. Is he a guy or a girl? You know, I've had many like discussions with my friends about that. I have no freaking idea. Do I care? No. Why? Because he freaking kills shit instantly. It's like freaking awesome. Pretty much, is he good for 3v3? Yes, he's very good at 3v3. So basically right here in this team fight, I said to my friends that I'd be guarding Baron while they would be, guarding the bush while they'd be getting Baron. Garen got pulled by Blitz, and then basically I just flashed in there, stunned everyone, me and Garen fucking shit up. We pretty much killed the whole team, and then at this point it's pretty much GG. We were losing for a bit, and then we caught back up. And then now we're just pretty much over and it's the end of the game. So this was Oh My God A Banana for a Kennen commentary. And remember guys, like and subscribe. Thank you.
Just push mid.
GG. Oh God, holy.
I told you this is good. I could have gotten another one.